Ladies and gents, today we're talking about ChatGPT and trading, and unfortunately, you're not going to be rich after watching this video, but you will learn a few ways to improve your research skills when it comes to trading and investing. So as usual, before getting the video, a quick reminder that all the best tools for day trading and investing will be linked in the description. That includes broker, scanner, charts, and newsfeed. Let's get in the video. When it comes to trading and investing, ChatGPT is going to be a great tool to help you. And I'll show you a few ways that I really think it's going to make a difference. A lot of guys are just going to tell you that they use it to look at charts and all that stuff. I don't think it's useful that way. But when it comes to news, it's something that's quite interesting and also researching. And I think that's the only way that it's really helping most people at this point. So right now you see I have ChatGPT-4. The reason why is that you want unlimited requests. If you're always limited on the amount of requests when you really need it, it's not going to be useful because you might be jammed up or just have to wait 24 hours just to reset. What's really important is that you're always using the same page or the same chat to send all of your requests, because it's going to remember at least what you sent and kind of the topic, and it's going to create really this memory of what you want to see. So it's going to be really personalized or helpful to you. I already have some stuff in this one, but what we're going to do is just show you some type of requests that I do and show you really how it helps me just navigate the financial market. So the first request we're going to do is look at what happened to Tesla. So Tesla has been a stock that's really, really in play. It went up a lot in the last few days. And also a big reason why, or the last reason why, is that they have their delivery numbers. So each quarter they tell you in advance how many units is being produced and how many is being delivered of each model. And this is quite important because you're talking about an EV or a product. So you want to know what's the progression. And also a lot of big investment firm, what they're going to do is look at these numbers to try to project their earnings and bet on these plays. So sometimes it's going to move as much as an earning release, but it's not the actual earning. This is where it gets a bit fun when you're trading, because you get the production number, you get also the earnings, gives you just more opportunity. So right now we can see, I'm just gonna take this page over here, and then after that, I'll move it and I'm gonna copy it over here and I'll just put a request. So right now I'll just put two dots here and I'll say, can you tell me the percentage increase from quarter to quarter for each unit? So now I send the request, and now it's just going to be a question of waiting for the response and see what number it gives me. What we're trying to see over here is just what is the number that it's increasing, and how can we compare it to other EV like Rivian or Nikola or stuff like that, so we can see like where our money should be investing, or what is the percentage maybe that we want to look for if we're trying to trade the next earning release to invest, or maybe just day trade. So we can see now it's starting to do the request, and which is really great about this is that you don't have to really go sit down and put out your Excel sheet or look at many websites that are going to try to charge you for each of these stuff. You can just have it over there and just select it and keep it in your chat. And we can see over here that we have all of the stuff that we need. By the way, if you enjoyed the video so far, don't forget to like, subscribe. I also did link all the best tools for day trading in the description. Don't forget to check that out. Let's get back to the video. Here's a good one, or stuff that I like to do, is I'd like to look maybe at Benzinga or any kind of platform that gives you data. Most of it, you can find it for free. And what I'll do is I'll just copy paste the page over here with their stats, and then I just copy to clipboard and put it over here. And then what I'll do is I'll go back to Benzinga and I'll look at Tesla. Then I go copy paste over here. Doesn't have to do something really clean. Just paste this one. And then I'm going to type the message. Can you compare these two company and tell me the difference? So then you can just send it. And then you wait a couple seconds and you should get the response. All right, so now that we're getting pretty much everything that we want in terms of financial, like a very clean comparison, here's some stuff that I like to look at that are quite important. So we're gonna stop it here because there's gonna be even more, but I like to look at first the market cap. So what is the company worth for each of them, right? 14 billion and 737 billion. Then this is pretty big. Then what you're going to see is the short float, you know, both about 18%, which is quite high. And this is pretty normal. People like to short these companies for some reason. And then we can see also the total assets. So Rivian has $15 billion. Tesla has $109 billion. This is where you can see the difference, right? Cash and short-term investment, 1.87 versus over here, 15 billion. And you can continue to really dig deep into the filing. And we can see over here, even if we go back, we can see gross profit margin quarterly, minus 43%, Tesla 17, minus 120%, and Tesla 5.30. So you can start to analyze company without having to really dig deep each line by each line, because it gives you a simple way. And then after, what you can do is says, give me a table for all this data. What you're going to get is a nice way or a nice sheet that you can keep a picture of it. And also it's good to create content. If you're looking to post on Twitter, this is a really, really good way. All right, so now we're getting the comparison table and we can see it's really, really nice. And it's a great way to really look at data. And if you're a swing trader, this could be even more useful because you have more time. And this is just the best way to improve your research and understand why some companies are worth a lot more than the other. I know these couple prompts are pretty obvious, but what's really important here is to build your model. So as more requests that you send in, the more precise it's going to be and the more it's going to understand what you want. So the last time I want a company comparison, this is what it's going to send me. And it's going to be really useful to make quick decision and just make a little bit of improvement in my overall research, because unfortunately, as everyone, I'm pretty lazy, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people who are going to watch this are also lazy when it comes to researching, even if you enjoy the stock market. So the last two ways we're going to be looking at how to improve your trading with ChatGPT are going to be with news. So over here, we can see that we have a news that came out. It was on Wednesday over here, and they had a private placement. So what I like to do is just copy paste the whole news over here and just say, can you summarize this for me? And then I just paste the news and then here we go. So when the news is really easy, sometimes you don't need this, but a lot of time when you're looking at biotech and the news is really, really complicated, they're talking about data, trial, this drug and this drug, then it just becomes confusing. And this is where it becomes really, really interesting. So now we can see over here what we have is key announcements. So the company over here agreement involved this amount of shares. Then you have the price over here, warrant, and all of that stuff. So when you have something like this, you don't really need something like dilution tracker or even flash SEC or some kind of dilution tool, because you're getting pretty much everything in ChatGPT already. So this is really important when you're looking at filings or even earnings or anything when it comes to research and data. And to be honest, I pretty much put every news piece in it just so it remembers and it just built a better model. And I really, really enjoy that, because at least I don't have to go through all the filings or just read all the line when I'm doing my pre-market prep. I can just look at what's the news, the headline, and just copy and paste this and have a big highlight of the important point of each stock that is moving, and it just makes it a bit quicker. So now we're getting to the last way that I'm actually using it to improve my trading and investing. And to be honest, this is just the best way. So as you guys are familiar, Nvidia has been the talk of the town. Now it's getting replaced by Tesla, but overall it was important. So a lot of things that are maybe a bit more complicated or you just want to understand, you can ask in ChatGPT. So a big move or a big stock that's still moving is ARM. So ARM Holding and also Nvidia. And then I want to know what's the relation between these two companies. And then it's going to break down what's the partnership, why is Nvidia and ARM correlated, why are both of these companies moving, and it's going to give you all the detail. So over here we can see relationship between ARM Holding and Nvidia. There was an acquisition attempt, but it got blocked, so you already know that it's pretty much a good company. But because over here we can see, if we stop this over here, we can see that despite the failed acquisition, Nvidia and ARM have maintained a collaboration partnership and continue to work together. And so now you can understand that why Nvidia is moving, ARM is also moving together, because they're a big investor in the company and there's some kind of synergy. Same thing as SMCI. You can say, why is SMCI related to Nvidia? And because you just asked this one, it's going to give you some kind of similar summary. And you can start doing this with every company. So a lot of time, a small cap is going to be holding, or a large cap is going to have some kind of partnership with a small cap. So you want to understand, you know, why is this one moving and what's the relation or what's the projected valuation? And it's a really, really good way to do things. So going back to the chat, we can see over here that they do have a partnership. And this is why, once again, when NVIDIA is going to start to move, you're going to have SMCI and ARM also moving. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.